Okay, very warm welcome to the IPPN Symposium. We're delighted to have you here in Mexico and at CIMIT. I'm sure many of you have never been to this campus before. It's a very lovely one and some great views. And I hope you have a very enjoyable week. So let's get going. The first talk will be by Dr. Ollie Shaw at the Jülich Institute. He's got a very long CV here and asked me not to read out all of the and asked me not to read out all of the great things he's done. And so I will not do that. And and I'll welcome him up to the stage. He's going to talk for 15 minutes to introduce and set the stage for the symposium. So thanks, Ollie.
Thanks, Matthew. Thanks very much for the introduction, and thanks very much also for hosting us here at CIMIT. I think it's a very good meeting and a very good, we already had a good start over the last 2 days already with a number of activities. Can you hear it? Oh, okay. The problem is I'm standing on a stage here. And I'm too big, so I'll probably have to go down here. Better? Okay, but I can't see my slides anymore. I will manage somehow.
Remember, in Mexico, we're not that tall.
Okay, I come down.
No, you can't go with it.
Okay, we'll manage that. Thanks very much for being here, and again, thanks very much for hosting us here. I want to start the International Plant Phenotyping Symposium, the fourth one here in CIMIT now, with shortly introducing to you to the IPPN, to the International Plant Phenotyping Network. And when I came to on stage, I actually realized that the first slide, there's the first mistake. I'm not Roland Piroshka, who is giving the talk, I'm Uli Schur. But nevertheless, I'll just shortly introduce you to the IPPN and what the IPPN is about. The IPPN is about collaboration to grow and develop a plant phenotyping community, a global plant phenotyping community. It's about combining researchers on plant phenotyping, users on plant phenotyping, developers of plant phenotyping gear. So it's a pretty wide community with a very wide target from different perspectives. Bringing all these together is pretty much key to develop the phenotyping field. It has been pretty much the key to developing the phenotyping community in the last, whatever, decade or so. And it's very important from our perspective to bring this together. And this was the reason why we started the IPPN as an official organization with a kickoff meeting in November 2015 in Barcelona, so more or less a year ago. And today IPPN is a member-based organization, a non-profit association, which we have founded, and you will find much more details on this based on that website, which you can see here. You see this slide? Yeah. And the reason, the mission of IPPN is to integrate regionally and globally fragmented activities, because obviously there's a lot of phenotyping activities going on in different parts of the globe necessarily, and we at the same time have to find integrated solutions on a global scale. We want to enable exchange of knowledge, information, expertise and capabilities between different groups who are running phenotyping, who are doing phenotyping, who are developing and who are using phenotyping. We want to provide a networking platform to link these diverse groups and to advise also decision makers on state-of-the-art phenotyping technologies and concepts, and to how to develop future opportunities and limits. So that's the mission goal which we set up for the IPPN in 2015. And there is a lot of development and opportunity there to support a global plant phenotyping community. I think that's the key message for IPPN, that we want to go in that route. These are the 25 members of IPPN so far. There are 25 institutions with the date of yesterday, and it's growing. So we have a pretty wide global coverage. There are obviously still some areas which we don't cover. Especially developing countries, but also a lot of countries in Asia. There are not too many members so far. but IPPN is open to new members. And we have yesterday in the general meeting, we also made a decision to offer reduced rates, which will be available for members from developing countries. So if there are people from developing countries who think about joining IPPN, we will hopefully in the next few weeks come up with a rate what this actually would be for developing countries. The IPPN also, together with other institutions, other organizations, made a survey on what kind of challenges are there for plant phenotyping. And the last one, which we did, it was in 2016. And you can see from that map that there was wide coverage from different parts of the globe, with a lot of participation from, participation from Europe, with more than 70% from European perspectives, but other continents also joining in there. And I think it's very important to see how this survey came out and what kind of challenges were mentioned there. The first challenge which was mentioned with most of the coverage was field phenotyping. And that's obviously obvious from the development which we had in the last decade or so, that we started from more controlled environment systems, now moving more and more into field, more and more moving into application in real breeding situations. There is a lot of discussions about abiotic stress and how abiotic stress will be challenged with phenotyping. Data management is another technical challenge, which we also have the opportunity to talk a little bit during this meeting. And root phenotyping, we already had yesterday a very interesting and broad coverage meeting of the root phenotyping group. So I think it's pretty obvious that there is a lot of challenges ahead of us. They are quite diverse. Interestingly enough, and that might be the opportunity, I take this as a positive point that IPPN is actually doing already a good job. Networking is the last one. So we already are in good shape with respect to networking. There have been a number of plant groups mentioned, the most part now in field and grain crops. This also has been a significant change compared to the early days of plant phenotyping of using non-invasive technologies, especially in field and grain crops, because therefore, and at the early stages, we started with model plants in growth chambers and in greenhouses. Today, we are really more talking about application in field and grain crops, and I think that's a very good development which is going on there. So seeing these kind of challenges and seeing this kind of wide diversity of activities there, it's very obvious that we need integration and need action on a global scale. What IPPN wants to provide is information and cooperation hub. So IPPN is organizing this kind of symposia. So we already have the fourth IPPS now, International Plant Phenotyping Symposium. We are also organizing workshops and meetings on different topics, summer schools, etc. So this is also an option where you will see which we use for developing a plant phenotyping community and transferring information. We established a number of working groups, and we'll tell you more about this in a minute. And there is an interactive website which gives you relevant information about plant phenotyping. About infrastructures, there's an infrastructure database, so if people are interested in what kind of infrastructures are available, you can look there, and you can also put your own infrastructure on there. We will set up an expert database, which is also a decision which you made yesterday in the general meeting, that there will be an expert database so that you can also connect to your expert colleagues. Last but not least, the old IPPN is only working if you participate in the IPPN activity. So it's not that IPPN is providing central services to everybody. It's really based on active participation of the community. And all this participation, all these activities are not closed to IPPN members only. They are open for the entire community. I think that's a very important part of the whole enterprise. So as I said, working groups are very important for the IPPN to develop things, and we have three active working groups so far. Root phenotyping, we yesterday had the root phenotyping workshop. We have an imaging working group, which is developing a strategy and processes and activities in this very moment, and there are also informations about this coming up on the website. And we started an affordable phenotyping working group, which is looking especially in phenotyping activities which are easy to use, which are cheap, which you can easily deliver to a wide range of people and users. Yesterday, we decided to have to develop four more phenotyping working groups within IPPN. One about phenotyping under controlled conditions, specifically focusing on climate change activities. We also think about phenotyping technology developments. Data management will be handled. Seed phenotyping will be a workgroup which we want to develop, and modeling is also a workgroup which we want to develop. So you see that there are, on the one hand, topical workgroups like root phenotyping. On the other hand, there are technological workgroups like imaging or data management. And we can have more workgroups depending on the interests of the members and the interests of the community. As I said, one of the important parts of IPPN is the International Plant Phenotyping Symposia. We had the 4 phenotyping symposia so far, one in Canberra, one in Munich, one in Chennai, and now the one here in Summit in Mexico. And yesterday we decided that the 5th International Plant Phenotyping Symposium will again go back to Australia. So the fifth International Plant Phenotyping Symposium will be at the University of Adelaide, taking place in September, October 2018. I'm not sure if we have a final presentation that at the end of the IPPS, but yesterday you already did quite well without slides, so you might do this again. So there are definitely the community is invited to go there, and it will definitely be a very interesting and good meeting. We also join IPN. IPN also joins other user communities. So just to give you some illustrations there, we will have 2 sessions at the International Botanical Congress, which are co-organized by IPPN. The abstracts can be submitted still, but the deadline will be pretty soon. So if you are interested in joining there, July 23rd to 29th in Shenzhen in China, the deadline is extended to January 15th. Look at the website of the IBC and you can register and submit your presentations and abstracts. There's another one in Interdrought, which takes place 21st to 25th of February, where there will be an IPPN workshop on precision phenotyping for improved stress tolerance. So these are 2 examples where IPPN actually is then linking up to the user communities, and if there are more relevant conferences which you know about where there could be a co-organization session with IPPN, we are very happy to do that and to bring the expertise of IPPN to other communities as well. We also decided yesterday in the general meeting that we want to start a discussion with industry. So far, IPPN is an academic institution, and we, from the beginning, before we actually started with IPPN, we already discussed how to link with industry. So yesterday, the general meeting gave a mandate to the board that we want to start discussions with industry, how to link IPPN with industry. The goal would be to get better interaction between academia and industry, including technology developers, seed companies, and beyond. We want to have better coordination across the entire phenotyping community, exchange of information, exchange about what is required, what is needed within industry, but also between industry and academia. We also think about developing joint symposia and better alignment of calendars, because if you look into the internet, you can see that at this very moment, next year, you will have the opportunity to go phenotyping conference every month easily. So there's a lot of activities going on there. We also want to address aspects of access to phenotyping gear with industry together. We want to talk about public-private partnerships there, and especially also fostering translation research from research which we have in the phenotyping community into the commercial sector. So this is definitely a thing which we want to develop, and hopefully industry is responsive to that. And from the discussions which I had so far with industry, I think there is a good opportunity to develop this in the future. So to our industry colleagues which are here, let's talk about options and joint interests together. We also do outreach, and one of the activities which we discussed yesterday as a kind of focal point would be the Fascination of Plants Day, which is the third Fascination of Plants Day, always taking place 18th of May 2017. So here we are trying to reach out to the general public. We discussed a number of means how to do that as a phenotyping community at IPPN, and how to organize different activities which are out there in the phenotyping communities to the groups. So if we are preparing some joint activities there for the Fascination of Plants Day in May 2017, and you are very welcome to join in there as well. So this is what I shortly wanted to tell you about the IPPN and recent developments which we discussed about yesterday. let me come up to the final statement here, which is probably more a personal statement than a official political statement of IPPN. Last week we had a meeting in Frankfurt about from the Weed Initiative, where also phenotyping plays a significant role. And one of the discussions which we had at that time was about game changers. Game changers which would change the entire field. And we, definitely there were a lot of people talking about new sequences and new technologies and things like that. I think there's one game changer which we all are somehow sensitive and exposed to. That's the game changer which I would say is the political situation where we see more protectionism, more nationalism, and more inward-looking activities in different countries. And that's probably a bigger game changer than any technology which you can think of. As a science community, and specifically a phenotyping community, how we worked in the past years, I think we are a good example that looking inward is not leading to the results. So, and especially being at CGR Center here, I think it's very clear that global perspectives are of importance. So I think phenotyping is a good community and a good example how to rapidly develop on the basis of, on the one hand, being aware that it's a global perspective, on the other hand, using many national funds, because we need national funds to support things. So I think it's in this political situation which we are here today, it's even more important than in the past that we are really getting strong together on a global scale here. We are needing a global science community, we need networking, we need interacting, and I think it's also a very important aspect of this meeting to come together, discuss these things, and really build a global community on plant phenotyping. Thanks very much.